Hi, I'm Liam Lyttle. When I was applying to become an NCP scholar, I did a lot of things first to make sure that I had the best application possible. First and foremost, I undertook some courses back home that I thought would help me prepare the knowledge I needed for my application and for my eventual placement in the region. So I undertook the anthropology of the Pacific Islands and the policy challenges of Asia Pacific security. And these two courses really gave me the foundational knowledge that I required in order to put my best foot forward in the application process. So I learned lots both about the challenges that Indo-Pacific faces through the policy challenges of Asia-Pacific security, but then I also learned a little bit more about the specific challenges of the Pacific Islanders and some of the regional history through my other course. What I would say to people looking to do their application is to first start with that kind of hard technical knowledge and then think back to what soft skills you have and what challenges you face in your personal life, what you can put forward in the application that makes you look like the best possible person to be selected for the NCP scholarship. And really personalize your application. So don't be afraid to think about the exact moments in your life that you've shown those three core skills. So for myself, I picked kind of moments throughout my artistic journey, which as a DJ producer, you wouldn't think, oh yeah, DJing is the thing that will get you a scholarship to come to Fiji, or, oh, because I made music with a group of people, I could show some leadership skills throughout that. But realistically, those kind of experiences that you might not think of as being exemplary qualities actually are. There's a lot that you can draw from your personal experience, regardless of what it is, that you can show to someone, hey, I'm actually a good fit to take this next step in life. I'm actually ready to grow and be someone that is worthy of obtaining this really prestigious scholarship. My advice for others interested in applying for the scholarship is to hone down on the three kind of core skills of the scholarship. So that's critical thinking, adaptability, and resilience. So really thinking about the moments in your life where you've shown those skills, and that can be a bit hard, but being able to articulate things like areas where you've been resilient really humanizes you to the selectors and allows you to put forward a case for being a really, really strong candidate that doesn't just have high academic achievement, but is able to show themselves and what they will bring as an Australian, as a mini ambassador of Australia to our region. And then it's to really focus on what country you'd want to go to. So really narrowing it down to your kind of top two potential countries, and then thinking about what it is you want to learn about them. Because the scholarship is not just about being a prescriptive policy person. It's not about coming and telling other people what we're doing or what they should be doing. It's about coming and learning. So really thinking what it is you wanted to learn about the country that you're applying for, or the region in particular that you're applying for, and then combining those two together to think about how your personal experience helps you be a better student of the country and region that you want to go to. But my biggest advice is to just apply. Apply for it, give it a crack. It will change your life if you do, like it has mine. But all you need to do is just start that ball rolling. There are so many people who are willing to help you, myself included, people from your home university. Everyone wants you to want this and wants you to succeed in it. So just give it a crack. It will change your life.